Got my 50 cal CVA. Shooting a 293 grain bullet by ITX. Pretty new and they look pretty awesome. Can't wait to try it out. So hopefully one of these does come out here in the food plot today, because Tothan and I, I was out by myself first thing this morning, and later in the morning Toth came to film me. You know, I saw 40 deer by noon. I could have shot maybe 15 out of those 40, and three of those were like under 20 yards at broadside, and that was when I was filming myself, but I couldn't make it happen, so I'm gonna film myself. Got my little homemade camera arm. This is just the top piece of a summit climber. I drilled a hole down through, I believe that's half inch pipe, half inch, and then it goes down to 3/8, I believe. I'm on a lock on. I just used the climber seat for my camera arm, and it's reduced down. I have a 90 nipple, another 90, and I just took a solid piece of bar and welded it, and I ground it down on the grinder. This is the top piece of my tripod, and that hole right there, that's where this will sit, right down on top of here, like this. Then I can move it back and forth, up and down. She's down right there. You can hear her crash. Oh yeah. I think I'm still breathing a little bit of smoke. Awesome. I got it done with the 50 cal. Early season, that is awesome. She didn't run. I hear her last kick down there. She didn't run to the other side of the food plot. She crashed right in the woods. This is awesome. She's down right there. can hurt or crash. Oh yeah, I got this second camera here too. I don't know if you can see it. Put this down. There's two other ones were right below me. I mean, she was 15 yards. So hopefully I got the backup shot, at least on me. I wanted it to get on there. Hopefully it's recording. Yeah. Well, I think I'm gonna get out. Lots of daylight left and see the carnage. There's the stand that I was in. And those deer come out right here. And she ran through here, come by, and she, I didn't see her until just now. There she is. I was just gonna point out, cause right here's where I saw blood. Cause I couldn't see her from right here. And I was looking for blood and she didn't bleed a whole lot, but she didn't run 40 yards. And she piled up right here. I can't believe that. I'll have to get in here and show you the shot placement, I guess, because she was quartering away pretty good. I mean, I aimed right there behind the shoulder, so. Anyways, and then I'll show you what these bullets look like that I'm using. She's not the biggest doe in the world. That looks far back, but actually it's, I mean, her leg was back and quartering away hard. I bet it come out. I don't know where it come out. Let me get the camera set up here, but there she is. Well, here it is. My first doe 2012. First deer 2012. Got it with the Flintlock here in early season, Pennsylvania. Nice, good-sized doe. Not the biggest doe in the world, but you make good eating. Just want to thank God for, you know, making it such a nice day, and just everything is just, everything's just going great. And just praise the Lord, that's awesome. You know, I just wanna thank all our subscribers and viewers all around the world. And you know, big thanks also to our men and women in the armed services. You know, it means a lot for you guys out there and, you know, home and abroad, you know, keeping us safe so we can come out here and enjoy this, our outdoor lifestyle. This is what these bullets look like right here. And then take these off. That's the bullet right there. That does an amazing job, as I see. Be using those from now on. Yep.
Pennsylvania. It's for doe only. Season's about a week long. Must wear orange in this season at all times. I'm using my Flintlock. You can use a Flintlock or an inline in this early season. But I got my 50 cal. It's a